Victoria Swanley.
Madam Speaker, recently families in Osoyoos learned that they may lose one or even both of their public schools because of Liberal cuts and unfunded cost pressures onto school districts. This is a decision that this local school board doesn't even want to contemplate, yet alone force onto this community. Without local schools for their children, there will be huge economic impacts on Osoyoos' ability to attract and keep businesses, skilled professionals, and skilled workers in this town. Last week, over 1,000 people attended an information meeting, and there the former mayor, Stu Wells, spoke up and said this: "This is a decision ultimately made by the Minister of Education. I'd like to see the Premier come to this town and tell us that they're going to close the school, because that's whose decision it is," and how right the former mayor is. So my question is to the Premier: can she explain here in this House to the people of Osoyoos how forcing school closures is somehow good for families, good for kids, and good for the economy of this town?
Minister of Education.
Well, thank you, Honourable Speaker. Closing a school is obviously never an easy decision. In fact, I've got personal experience. We've had to shut a couple of schools down within my district. When you have declining enrollment, Honourable Speaker, those are tough decisions that need to be made. But those decisions are best made at the local level. The local school district, Honourable Speaker, they're the ones that understand the needs, the demands, the experiences that they have in the area is really what drives the decisions that are best made for the students in that area. And Honourable Speaker, unlike the member opposite, we feel that's the best place to make the decision, is the locally elected school board, to make sure that they are respectful for the decisions for the students in their area.
Victoria Swan Lake on a supplemental.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. When funding for education in this province goes from second best in the country to ninth worst in the country, when we have $1,000 less per student than the Canadian average, as we do in British Columbia, the decision is being made by the Minister of Education, by the Premier, by the Liberal government, not by local school boards, Madam Speaker. The sad thing for Osoyoos is that the current MLA, the member for Boundary Similkameen, has even failed to show up to public meetings thus far on school closures. She hasn't offered any ideas or even empathy to stop the closure of the schools. This isn't closing a school in the town of Osoyoos. It's closing all the schools in Osoyoos, Madam Speaker, and I would remind the minister of that. This is what the local MLA said to her constituents, quote, "There really is nothing I can say that will bring any level of comfort to the people of Osoyoos." That's the representation people from Osoyoos get from Liberals on that side of the House, Madam Speaker. And let me remind the minister of this, Madam Speaker. The schools in Osoyoos are not empty. They have hundreds of students in each. Osoyoos Elementary has a capacity of 325 students, and it has 317 students in that school this year, Madam Speaker. The secondary school enrollment is growing in Osoyoos as well. What this government has failed to understand, Madam Speaker, is the impact that these closures will have on families and communities. So, question to the minister is this: will he admit that this government's disastrous $54 million cut for so-called low-hanging fruit is precisely why rural schools are being contemplated for closures? And will he stop? Will he stop turning his back on communities like Osoyoos and instead stand up for towns like Osoyoos so they can keep their schools?
Minister of Education.
Well, thank you, Honourable Speaker. You know, one thing that we're really fortunate about here in the province of British Columbia, because we have the best economy in Canada, that's why we've got the best investments. Honourable Speaker, it's because of that because of that, we have record investment in our education system, Honorable Speaker. I also want to correct the member opposite, Honorable Speaker. The member from Boundary St. Milkameen has done an excellent job bringing all of the concerns and the issues of her constituents forward to me on a daily basis. You know, and one more thing I'll mention, Honorable Speaker, since we're on a roll here and try to correct the member opposite. We have a 42% increase in this province on per student funding. It's a record, Honorable Speaker, in the province of Canada, for all of Canada, a record investment for our students.